So welcome to this video where we'll be looking at MAC and collision detection. The purpose of this video is for you to understand the advantages and challenges with collision detection for dynamic access strategies in the MAC layer. Before we were talking about CSMA, which was carrier sense multiple access, where we were actually able to sense the channel and to listen before we were transmitting. However, when collisions can be detected, we can optimize the protocol even further. So the difference here is that when we are trying to detect, so with CSMA, with this carrier sense, then collisions can still happen. For example, because we start to transmit two senders at the same time, or because there can be senders and transmitters who cannot hear each other. When we can do collision detection, then we can optimize the protocol even further. The problem is that when transmission of two or more packets overlap in time, then they are lost and they must be retransmitted. In some local area networks, and we know, for example, Ethernet is an example of it, then we can detect interference among several transmissions, even when the transmission is in progress. So if a collision is detected during the transmission is aborted, so we don't have to wait by this keeping on sending a packet, which is basically, we know, will not be transmitted correctly. So that is for Ethernet. Then for radio systems, is this still possible? Think about it. There are some challenges again when trying to do it. So when we're talking about a wire, then the transmitter and the received signals are of the same order of magnitude. So when you are sending a signal and you have a collision somewhere, you are still able to kind of hear it because you can hear the signals you receive. The problem is with wireless, then the signal you are sending is much, much stronger than the signal you're receiving. So in radio systems, collision detection is usually not implemented. And this leads to the fact that we have to receive an acknowledgement to be sure that actually the transmission worked out well and there was no collisions. So let's try to look at some of the problems that we have in the wireless systems. There are two classical problems that I will go through. One is the hidden terminal problem, and one is the exposed terminal problem. So if you look at the figure here and assume the following situation, that A sends to B and that C cannot receive A. So A is sending to B, but C cannot hear what is going on. Because C cannot hear what is going on and he wants to send to B, he considers the medium to be a free medium. He doesn't hear anything. So he starts sending. The problem is that then we have a collision at B, and A cannot receive the collision here, and also C doesn't know what is going on. So it's called the hidden terminal problem because A is hidden for C. And we have a similar problem which is called the exposed terminals problem. So assume now that B is sending to A and C wants to send something to another terminal that could be terminal D in the figure here or something far away. Now C is sensing that it has to wait because the carrier sense feels that the medium is in use. So because C can hear that B is sending, he will wait by sending. But this is not a real problem, right? Because A is outside the radio range of C. So when C is sending to someone who cannot hear A or B, there is no problem. And then we say that C is exposed to B, so he refrains from sending, even though he could actually do it. So to try to solve some of these problems, what we use is what is called multiple access with collision avoidance, which is using short signaling packets for collision avoidance. And the idea is that instead of just starting to send, then we have this first period where we try to negotiate it. So what we do first is that if you want to send something, then first of all you send a request to send. So what you get is that you really want the permission to be sending. So We want this permission from the receiver, so we send the RTS packet from the sender to the receiver before the actual data packet. Then in order to respond and confirm that this is okay, the receiving part will send a CTS, a clear to send, as soon as it's ready to receive. And it means that before we actually have a transmission between A and B, then both A and B has confirmed that this is going to take place. So everyone who can hear an A and B will know that this is going on. This signaling packet will contain the send address, the receiver address, and the packet size. And the good thing is that it allows others who are listening to the channel to know that they should hold back. So basically, we avoid the problem of hidden terminals. So assume now, again, just for illustrating it, that A and C, they both want to send to B, and that A first send a request to send, and then B will be sending the CTS, this permission to send, and then C know that he should be waiting. So the problem we had with the hidden terminal before, we don't have it when we're using the MAC-A. We can, the problem is a little bit different with exposed terminals. So we know that at the end of transmission, the acknowledgement is required. But this four-way handshaking, it doesn't really eliminate the exposed terminal problem. So let's assume again that B wants to send to A and C wants to send to another the terminal. The problem is that if C will initiate another transmission, then the acknowledgement from A will collide with the data from C to B. So we still have this exposed terminal problem. And here at the last slide, I will just show some taxonomy of the MAC protocols, which I encourage you to study. And basically, it also shows the division between the dynamic and static allocation that we have been discussing in the video so far.